This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, perfect. So yesterday, what was the thing we have discussed?
Yesterday, we were talking about the queues, right? I mean, distributed queues, right? Like.
Okay, so basically the technical introduction part has been completed yesterday, right?
Yeah, that's what my understanding, correct me if I'm wrong. Because I joined in the partially, so.
Okay, so yesterday technical introduction has been completed. I mean, what is a queue manager, what is a queues, what their definitions, the basic technical introduction has been completed. So today we will move on. So in today's session, hope you guys can see my screen.
Yeah.
Okay. So in today's session, we are going to learn the NQ9 installation in Linux 7 operating system. Okay. So today we're going to learn about the installation, how to do NQ9 installation. Okay. Clear?
Yeah. Whoa. Yeah, before you start in the installation, can I ask one question? Like,
yeah, please.
Okay, what is the difference in the futures wise with the MQ9, 8, and 7.5?
Okay, so yeah. Actually, from MQ6 to MQ7, there okay. are very, very good enhancements. Okay,
can you? Okay.
Yeah, I'll tell. So, from MQ7 to MQ8 and MQ8 to MQ9, there are no much enhancement, but there are minor changes in terms of security and all.
Okay.
Okay, so let me do like this. I think if you can Google it, you will get it. But let me explain about this. So the difference between MQ6 and 7, it's not the difference, I would say. It's an enhancement. Really, really big enhancements are there. Enhancements means big, huge. Changes means that are very small. So the first enhancement from 6 and 7 is the multi-instance concept. Okay, this is really a big enhancement.
Okay.
The second thing is, it's a PubSub. So in MQ6, there is no PubSub concept in MQ, but from MQ7, PubSub concept has been introduced.
Okay. So in MQ7 only the PubSub. Before that MQ6 there is no PubSub concept. That's what you think,
no,
right?
There is no PubSub concept.
So how when we used to do that, you know, the PubSub configuration, is it different? Broker, right? Correct.
There is no PubSub concept in MQ6. You can't do that. Actually, let me tell you one thing. MQ is mainly designed for point-to-point setup only. It is not designed for PubSub.
Okay.
Okay. So point-to-point means it has to go to the exact point. That's all. But PubSub is the sender should not aware of the receiver things and all. So they will just blindly publish a message based on topic, and the subscribers, the consumers, will consume the message. That's how PubSub is. But MQ is not designed for that. MQ is intended for point-to-point.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. So, but okay. PubSub has been introduced from 7 to fulfill some of the business requirements. To say you frankly, okay. PubSub is not widely used in MQ. Okay. So, till now, I have seen very, very minimal scope of PubSub in my experience in MQ. MQ okay. is mainly for point-to-point. Anyway, in the PubSub concept, I will explain you more what it is.
Sure.
And the third thing is the channel authentication records. This is also one of the biggest ever enhancements from 6 to 7. So channel authentication records means we can provide the security in the channel level.
Okay.
Okay. So how to provide the channel level security means, like, there are some conditions, like, if the connection is coming from this particular IP, I need to enable the authentication. I need to access the queue manager. So that is channel level authentication. And
okay.
if the requirement is, if the connection is coming from the particular user, then only the connection has to be established through the particular queue manager. So for these kind of requirements, IBM introduced a concept called channel authentication records. From there onwards, we can enable all these kind of flexibilities.
Okay,
so anyway, these are very, very advanced right now to discuss about.
No, just from an, the reason why I'm asking, you went to the 9, right? So I didn't know the differences. What is the changes in 6 and 7 and 8? So that's the reason I was asking you this question.
No, let me give a clarity on the question. If you ask the changes and if you ask for the enhancements, there is a big difference, Sai. So the thing is, enhancements is really huge difference.
Okay.
Changes means some minor changes, that's all.
Okay, so let me phrase you this way. Okay, so what are the enhancement? Okay, whereas like 6 and 7, 8, okay, the future survives. Okay, so this one have, as you mentioned, like multi instant PubSub and the channel authentication records, right? So these are like, can say like these are features, right? The advanced features of the 6 and 7, right?
Right, exactly. These are the features from 6 to 7.
Okay,
and if you ask me from the enhancement from 7 to 8, there are no much enhancements, but there are very, very minor changes in concept of security wise. I mean, technically there are much changes, but the business wise there are the changes. So let me tell over that. Okay, and changes from 8 to 9, I would say technically no, from 8 to 9.
Mm-hmm.
But business wise, yes. Like from MQ9, IBM introduced two kind of versions, like LTS support and CD, continuous delivery. Okay, so LTS means long term support.
Mm-hmm.
CD in the sense continuous delivery. So these are not technical changes, these are business level changes. Okay, so for example, LTS means generally this is the standardized version where we need to use our real time versions,
okay,
especially in the production systems. And continuous delivery means IBM will keep on delivering these versions, like, hey, we have this changes, can you please install this version? After that, IBM introduced one more fix pack, and can you please install this version? So this is like a continuous delivery. IBM will keep on delivering the versions.
Okay.
Okay, but the recommended and standard way is long-term support version for MQ9.
Okay. So that means you mean to say, like, in LTS, you will not be having any defects or anything like that?
No,
I fixes or any defects, nothing, right?
Nothing. LTS means it's already fixed and we are converting as a long term support.
Okay.
But continuous delivery version means it may change in near future for sure.
Okay.
So these are business level changes. Technically, there are no much enhancements from 7 onwards.
Okay.
And if you ask me from 7 to 8, what are the exact difference? Even I also don't know, because I don't see any differences between 7 to 8.
Because the question, why I asked this question, is you were asking the Google, right? I mean, even if you do the difference between, I mean, even in the IBM side, there is no, I don't see any difference, 8, 7, 8, and 9. Okay?
That's right.
I mean,
the only biggest enhancements I could see is from 6 to 7, because when I started my career, I have started my career with MQ6. I mean, 7 years, mm-hmm, when I started my first job, I started working, mm-hmm, on MQ6. Okay, and when we started migrating on MQ7, then I was able to understand all these concepts.
Okay.
So this is the thing what I can see. And changes, no, I don't see any changes from 7 to 8. And changes from 8 to 9, yes, business level, there are the changes, but technically, I don't see any.
Okay, yeah, thanks.
No, is it clear question?
Yeah. Thanks.
All right, so let's move on. We'll do one thing. Let me save this and let me share it with you. Now, okay. So in today's session, we are going to learn the MQ9 installation in the Linux 7 operating system. Okay. Okay, so before starting the session, let me ask you one question. So if I want to install any software, I mean, I have my personal laptop and I want to install one software. So shall I install it directly? Blindly shall I proceed for the installation or shall I do something?
You want to say the prerequisite, like what is the prerequisite for this one to open?
Exactly, exactly. I'm talking about the prerequisites. So to proceed for the installation, first of all, we need to check the prerequisites. I mean, what are the prerequisites the system should meet before doing the installation? Then only the prerequisites are satisfied, then only we will proceed for the installation, right? The thing is, if we have not checked for the prerequisites and we blindly proceed for the installation, I am pretty much sure the installation may be failure in the future at any time. Because prerequisites are having a very, very key role to give a support for any kind of software, right? So in the same way, to install MQ9, we need to meet some prerequisites. Okay, so they are like this. Can you see this document, MQ9.0 installation Linux?
Yeah.
Okay, and I hope you both knows about the Linux commands. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. So now let's see the prerequisites. So the first prerequisite to install MQ9.0 is we need to have Linux 7 operating system. This is the first thing. If you want to install MQ9 on Linux 6 operating system, no, that is not possible. MQ9 definitely needs to have Linux 7 operating system. So now the thing is, I am already in a Linux machine. This is my already a Linux machine in my VM. Okay. So I want to install MQ in this machine. So first of all, I need to check if this machine is a Linux 6 or Linux 7. So how to check that? This is the command, cat etc red hat release. So the thing is, cat etc red hat release. If I do this, it is saying Red Hat Enterprise Linux release 7.3. Okay, I have Linux 7 operating system. Yes, this operating system definitely supports for MQ9. So the first prerequisite is met. Okay.
Okay.
Now the second thing is user MQM and group MQM should be created. MQM user should be a member of MQM group. Now it's a group or user creation. So the thing is, in this machine, we need to have a user called MQM and a group called MQM, and this user MQM should be a member in MQM group. So this is the second prerequisite. Now the question is, how to check if MQM user exists or not? It's very simple. There is a command called id. Okay. Id space, give that particular username you are looking for. If I give this, if the user is exist, then it will show the output like this. Okay, MQM user is there, and which is a member of GID means group ID, which is a member of MQM group. So MQM user is there, MQM group is there, and MQM user is a member of MQM group. So the second prerequisite is also met. Now, the third prerequisite is the file systems. So we have to make sure there are two file systems, where MQM and OPT MQM file system should be created. Okay, let me ask you a question here. Do you aware what is where file system and what is OPT file system in Linux?
Whereas where MQM is talking about all the like library with the cron entries and all the values will be in the where slash.
I am not okay. asking about var MQM, I am just asking about slash var. What is the use of slash var and what is the slash, I mean, what is the use of slash OPT in Linux?
Slash var is for log folders, right?
Okay, instead of technical, can you tell me in the general English? I am not asking technical words.
See, it's basically it's like a variable entry can if work, slash var is okay. Whereas in the kernel level, everything will be like in the var. If you look at the syslogs, okay, syslogs, everything will be in the var log, syslog only.
Okay, so you were giving me the explanation. Instead of the explanation, any idea, what is the basic purpose of var? What it will do? Okay, no problem, let me explain. So var and OPT. So in the Unix level, where file system and OPT file systems lies under the root file system. So slash means it's a root file system. Hope you already aware of it.
Okay.
And where is a working directory in the Unix? Instead of Unix, let me do like this in the Linux. So working directory in the sense, for example, if we are working on a particular technology, so the associated logs, the associated entries will be in the where file system because it's a working directory.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and OPT is the installation directory in Linux. So for example, if I install MQ, the binaries are going to store in the slash OPT. This is the default behavior of Linux operating system. And if I install VAS, Webspire application server, that binary is also going to install in the OPT only, because by default it is going to OPT is the installation directory for any third party software in the Linux operating system. So got an idea now what is VAS file system and what is the OPT file system?
See, I mean, if you see like if using like the Webspire, right? So like if in AX and everything, okay, if you see it's going to slash user, okay.
Exactly. In the AX operating system, in the AX operating system, by default, slash user is
insertion directory.
This is for AX. That's why I have mentioned it. This is only for Linux. Okay, so it's an operating system level change. So as we're working on Linux,
correct me if I'm wrong. Okay, it's based on the. So you're saying the slash OPT is the basically like it's a default file system installation directory, right? That's what.
Yes, it is default installation directory for Linux, not for AX.
Okay.
For AX, and you are right. The default installation directory would be slash /usr. Okay, but so, the working directory is same in both Linux same and AX. It is slash /var. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
As we are working on Linux, let's concentrate on Linux only.
Okay, sure.
Okay. Now, the file system we need to have is varmkim and opt in here. So it means that we need to make sure varmkim file system is there and slash opt npm file system is there. So now, the varmkim file system is working directory for npm related stuff, and opt npm is the installation directory for npm related stuff. I mean mq related stuff. Okay. So, I mean the thing is, when we create a queue manager or when we create a queues, the physical entries will be under var npm. Because it's a working directory, and when we install MQ9 software, MQ9 binaries, those binaries will be located in the OPT npm. That is the reason we need to make sure these two directories are exist first. Okay, and make sure varmkim have 25 GB of space. It's a minimum. And OPT npm is also having 25 GB. So this is the recommended one. Okay, so to check if the file system exist or not, the command is df. Df stands for disk free. Hope you already aware of this command. So df-pth, and when you give slash varmkim, it will show the output like this. For example, let me go to my Linux machine. Let's do like this. df-h varmkim. If I do this, okay, it is showing me the mount point details. So varmkim is there, which is 28 GB, and out of 28 GB, 7.1 GB is used and 21 GB is free. It means varmkim is there. And if I want to see for the OPT npm file system, the command would be df-h OPT npm.
Okay.
Yes, OPT npm file system is also there. Okay, so let me tell you one point here. In the real time, if we need to install MQ, and you are checking for the file system and you find that, okay, the file systems are not there. Now, what will you do? Will we create the file systems?
We'll request operating system to.
Exactly. We need to request, these are operating system level jobs. So we need to request the Unix team, hey, I need to have this file system with the 25 GB. Can you please help me? So when we place the request, yes, they are going to create these two file systems. Even creating MKM user, MKM group also not AMQ responsibility. It's a admin, Unix admin responsibility. We have to place a request to Unix team so that they will help us.
So one more question, like when you're creating this MQM group, user ID as the group, right? So like, do you have any, like we have criteria, I think something, right? I mean, we had to keep it in the root group level, right? For MQM ID, is not there?
No, not required.
So how about the GSK? I mean, so when you install the GSK, I mean, like in the, during the upgrade, it should be like,
no,
like what is the root level permission you need, right? No.
No, no, root level, to install MQM packages, definitely you need to have the root level permission.
Okay, if the, if you user ID MQM group ID, user ID is not part of root, so how is it going to install?
Okay, I got your question. Okay, let's do one thing. Let's complete the prerequisites first.
Sure.
Okay, when we complete the prerequisites, you will get the answer for your question.
Sure, okay.
Okay, so if I forget, you just remember me.
Sure, yeah.
I'm sure you will get the answer for your question once we met the prerequisites.
Sure, okay.
So, but bottom line is, it is not at all mandatory that MKM should be a user level group. No, that's not required.
Okay.
Now, the fourth requirement is, we need to have the appropriate MQ software dump in a temporary location. So, obviously, we need to have the dump, right? So consider I am placing my dump in the var tmp. So in this machine, I already have the dump. So cd var tmp, I mean var tmp path. If I do ls, there is a directory called mq. So this thing I already created, and I already placed the dump here. This is my trial version for the Linux operating system. Okay, and for you guys, I will provide the entire VMware dump, a Linux ISO image, this MQ software dump, everything I will provide you after the session. Okay, sure. I will share you the Google Drive links, so you can download them, and I can share you the instructions also, how to do the VM setup and dump.
Okay,
now the fifth question is, here, Sai, I think here you will get the answer for your question. So we need to have the access for root user. Okay, the thing is, root user is the super level user in the Unix level. With the root user, you can do anything like installation, uninstallation. You can build the system, you can crash the system with the help of root user. Because root user is an administrative account, and when we do any kind of installation, we need to have access for the root user. And then we can do the installation. So here I am already into root user. Okay, if I do, who am I? Yes, I am a root user. It means I can proceed for the installation. Okay. The thing is, getting the root access or we're not get the root access, it depends on project to project size. So the thing is, some projects they may allow, yes, you can take the root access, but in some critical and sensitive projects, no. You are not supposed to get the root access because you are just an MQ admin, right? So here the thing is, the cases would be like this in the root, getting the root access. The first thing is, you will get the root access in some projects. The second case would be, you will need to ask Unix admin to install MQ packages. It means we will provide them the packages list and we will provide them the commands how to do the installation with the root user, so that Unix team will do on our behalf. Later on, we will do validation. So here we need the cooperation with the Unix team. So this could be the second case. And the third case would be, you will get a temporary, root access for some time. Maybe for 30 minutes, maybe for 1 hour, they will give you the root access. After that, it will be automatically revoked. So some projects would be like this. And some projects would be, you will get installation permissions to install MQ packages. I mean, there are input packages which we will need to install. So to install those packages, yes, your account will be having the access. They will do this. So definitely the case would be any of these things, whether you may get a permanent root access, or you will need to depend on Unix team to install MQ packages, or you will get the root access for some time, or you will get the installation permissions for MQ packages to be installed on that machine. So case would be definitely one out of these four. It depends on project to project. Okay.
Okay.
So is that answer your question?
There's a one more thing to add here. Okay. Like, for example, if I want to install, okay, if they're saying the root, they're not giving the root access, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, is it not, we can able to install with non-root access, we can install the MQ?
No. You will not get the access. You will not, you will definitely not installing, you will definitely can't install MQ packages without root access. Because when we install MQ packages, back and what happens is, it will update the operating system kernel level changes. Okay, kernel level changes in the operating system level can be happen with the root user only. Non-root user, no, you can't.
Okay, so if for example, if just it may be hypothetical case, okay, like if I'm installing with the root, okay, so the all the packages will be installed on the root, okay. So when we able to log into the root, it should be now in the MQM, right? So once the root is installed, then they change the permission to all the owner permission to MQ. So that's what the thing is?
No. It is also not required. Because see, MQ installation means it will update the Unix level kernel, and Unix level kernel is having only with the root. That's all. Okay. Once your packages are installed with the root, you can log in as a MQM user and you can perform all your MQ operations. It doesn't require that you need to have the root user or you need to change the permission for your installed package in the kernel level. No, it's not the point.
So, okay, when you install a root, okay, all the package installed in the root, okay, the file system is owned by root only, right?
Correct. Exactly.
Okay. So you will be logging as a MQM, okay? Mm-hmm. MQM ID should have a so it will not say the privilege issue.
No, it will not give you the privilegiation. The thing is, once we install MQ packages with the root user, the final step is we need to set our MQ as the primary installation. Okay, so I will give you full-fledged explanation about the primary installation during the installation time. So just hold up for a few minutes.
Sure.
Once we set it as a primary installation, right, with the MQ matches, you will be able to execute your MQ commands.
Okay, fine. Okay, let's see. Yeah, and do you have any property file like VPD property file, something like that? As you mentioned, I understand. Okay, you don't have anything, right?
Nothing. Okay. Let me tell you one thing. Do not compare MQ with other technologies because
No. I'm just asking.
I'm not saying it. I got your question, but what I'm saying is do not compare because every technology is independent. Every technology has its own purpose. Every technology has its advantages and also its limitations.
Okay.
So the thing is, according to our business requirement, according to our framework, we have to choose appropriate technology. That's all. So the thing is, don't compare the technologies. If we compare, now what happens is we may get confused. Hey, in this technology I have this thing, but in this
My question is not. I mean, see, recently I'm not comparing the technology. The reason why I ask this question is you said you're the root level. When you install in the root, the kernel level parameters need to be updated, right? So that's how I was asking you. Okay, so the MQ does it have anything like? Packages which you don't need the root level. This is my question actually. I mean, the background I was thinking about this stuff, not about the exactly.
It's not like that.
Okay. So one thing is mandatory. Always we have to install with the root only, right?
Exactly.
MQ, there is no other way. Fine.
No, there is no other way.
Yeah.
Okay. So whether you need to have the root access or you need to get the installation permission for your user ID to install that particular MQ package.
Okay, got you.
Okay, so let's proceed with the installation now. So we have met with the prerequisites. Hope you got understand about the prerequisites now. Hope you have no doubts.
Yeah, I'm clear.
Okay, and Vivek, you are also clear?
Yes.
Okay. Now let's start with the installation procedure. So the installation procedure is having how many steps? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Very simple. So first of all, we need to switch to root user. Okay. So root user means only with the root user only we can do the installation. So I am already in my Linux machine and I am already into root user. If you see here, yes, I am into root. Where am I? I am root. Yes, I am root user.
Can you exit and come to go to root again? What command are you passing? Sudo hyphen su or something?
I didn't get your question. What's the question?
I mean, can you exit from root?
I exited from the Unix machine itself.
Okay. If you are directly, it is going to root.
Yeah, exactly. So this is my Linux machine, na? I know the root password.
Okay. Generally, we use the sudo hyphen su command to go to root. Right?
Exactly. That I will come to that. Hold on.
Okay.
So this is my VM machine. So and I'm just getting the IP address to connect to Putty. So this is my IP address. So let me open Putty. Hope you know what is Putty tool.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
135.1.4. Okay. Here it is asking as a login as. I'm just logging as root, and I know the root password because this is my VMware. I'm logged in as a root. Okay. So generally in real time, you will log in as your ID. I mean, there will be initial level access for your ID. After that, you will switch to su something like this.
Yes.
Sudo su hyphen like this, so that you will be switching to root user. Okay. Is that answer your question?
Yeah, so is it same for all the organizations, sudo su hyphen, or it is different for each organization?
It will be again different. So some organization allow only sudo level access, which user access.
Okay.
It depends on organization. There is no, I can't give a sure answer, but the options could be either this or could be either this.
Until and unless we check with someone in the organization, we don't come to know that.
Exactly. That's true. Okay. Anyway, let's do not concentrate on the user accounts and all. That depends on project to project. Let's concentrate on MQ installation. Okay. Fine. So now the second thing is, we need to go to the path where MQ software dump is placed. Okay, currently my software dump is placed on var tmp. So I consider that I did FTP or I did WinACP from some server to the server in var tmp. Now I am in var tmp, and when I do ls-lrt, yes, I can see a directory called mq. Now I'm in var tmp mq. When I do ls-lrt, yes, here is my dump. Okay, so this is the dump for MQ9, which is a trial version. If you see this file is having .tar.zip, gunzip file we are having. Yes, so we have the appropriate dump also. Now, the third thing is, we need to unzip that file. I hope you know what is a zip file and how to unzip it.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. So to unzip a file, the command would be gunzip, and then give your gunzip file name. When we execute this, so it will take some time because it is having almost 700 MB of size. So it will take a couple of minutes. So let's wait.
So installing virtual machine, are you going to share any software?
I will share you the instructions how to install the VMware. Okay, it's pretty simple.
Okay.
So right now, just concentrate on MQ installation, the installation instructions of VMware information. You just follow it. It is very, very simple.
Yeah, just answer.
Yeah, so now it's gunzipped. When I do ls minus lrt, see, now for this file, dot gz extension is gone. It means now it's not a gunzip file anymore. It's just a tar file.
Okay.
Now, when we have the tar file, we need to untar the file. So untarring means we are unzipping all the packages. We are extracting all the packages. So to untar the file, the command would be tar-xvf. Xvf stands for extended verb format. It means we are extending all the packages which are in this tar file. So when I click this, if you see, there is a directory called MQ server. Inside this directory, all the packages are getting uninstalled. If you see, MQ series is a package. MQ, see, can you see the changes?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's wait another couple of minutes because it will definitely take some time. See, now these are the packages which are getting uninstalled. Okay, it's done now. So we are in RTMP MQ. Ls minus lrt. Do you see now? There is a directory called MQ server has been created.
Yes.
So previously this directory was not there before untarring. When we untar the file, a directory called MQ server has been created, and inside this directory, all the MQ packages are created. Now go to this directory, MQ server. Now we are in RTMP MQ. MQ server, and when I do ls minus lrt, yes, here are my packages. Okay, let me decrease the size so that it's not changed. Oh, what happened? Okay. Anyway, you can see the package list now, right? MQ series runtime, SDK,
yeah.
Samples, client. All these are the MQ packages which we need to install for the successful MQ installation. Okay. So the thing is, before going to MQ install, let me do one thing. I think MQ is already there. Let me uninstall it. Okay, packages are already there. I'm just let me remove that.
Generally, for uninstall, we use uninstall here rpm-ev.
No. Here rpm-ev erase. E stands for erase. We are erasing the package.
Okay.
And rpm stands for Red Hat Packet Management. This is specifically for Red Hat Linux. Okay. Now there are no packages. So let me clear. And that's minus select. Okay. Now these are the packages which we need to install. The thing is, before proceeding for the installation,
we have to delete the directories as well, right?
No, not required. Deletion of directories not required. Okay. Okay. Now let me ask you one question. So see, when we install any software in our Windows, in our personal computers. So, do you understand it will be a GUI mode and we will click on next button and it will ask an option called I accept the license agreement. Do you remember that?
Mm-hmm.
So the thing is, what is meant by that? First of all, we need to accept the terms and conditions of that particular license, then only a particular software will be installed, right?
Mm-hmm.
So in the same way, before proceeding for the MQ packages, we need to accept the MQ licenses. Okay, so to accept the MQ license, there is a file called mqlicense.sh here. Do you see this?
Yeah.
So we have to take the help of this file to accept the license. So it is /mqlicense.sh --accept. This is the command to accept the license for MQ. When I click this, let's enter one to accept the agreement. So click on enter. Okay, now see, agreement accepted, proceed with the installation. It is giving us some confirmation, right? Hey, agreement has been accepted, you can proceed for the installation. When we got this information, then only we are good to install. So the thing is, if agreement is not accepted and installation can't be done, it means no, something went wrong. Your prerequisites are not met. Okay, so in MQ, when we execute a command, we need to read the output and we need to understand the output, then only take the next action. Okay, without understanding output, don't do anything. Got it?
Yeah.
Okay. Now agreement has been accepted. So what is my next step? Okay, this is the thing what we have done. Now we have accepted the license also. Now
rpm-h.
Yes, we need to install the MQ packages. So these all are our MQ packages. Okay. Now, out of all these packages, we no need to install all these packages. We have to install, there are some basic 6 to 7 packages. When we install those packages, that is more than enough. Okay, so those packages are MQ series runtime package, SDK package, samples, client, Java, JRE, and MQ series server package will be there. Where it is? MQ series server.
Can you go a little bit up?
Okay. Oh, where is
runtime SD?
Strange, yeah. Okay, here it is.
Yeah, the last one, yeah.
Okay, these are the 6-7 packages we need to install.
Can you repeat what is the first one? Like runtime?
Yeah, runtime.
Okay.
So first install runtime, then the remaining package could be any other, because runtime package is the base package. This is the foundation package. So for example, if we are constructing a house, first of all, we need to have the foundation, then only we can build a ground floor, then first floor, then second floor, and we can go on. Right?
Okay.
So without foundation, we can't construct a building, right?
Mm-hmm.
Same way, without installing runtime first, we can't install the remaining packages.
Okay, so first one we have to run the runtime, then what is second package?
Now it could be any order. There is no order from the second package.
So basically the runtime, SDK, samples, then what are the other packages?
Server.
Server, okay.
Okay, then Java, JRE,
okay.
Then
okay.
SDK, this one.
So I just want to repeat it, okay? The runtime,
okay.
SDK, sample,
okay.
Server, Java, and JRE, right?
Exactly. So I will do one thing. I will write down the command and I will share you this document with you. So this document is having all the required packages which need to be installed.
So basically six packages you mentioned.
Yeah, exactly, 6 packages.
Okay.
All right. So I am installing the first package, which is a runtime. So for installing a package, the command would be like this in Linux: rpm -ivh mq series runtime. So this is the package. I just did a copy paste, that's all. When I click on enter button, now see, it is installing. Some hash keys going on to show the progress of installation. Okay, now it's 100% done. Now runtime has been installed. Okay, now to verify if runtime is installed or not, there is one more command, rpm-qa, which stands for query call. pipegrep-imq. Hope you know what is this pipe, what is this grep, everything.
Yeah.
Okay, now see, it is showing runtime package. It means runtime package is now in the operating system. Okay,
so
now let's
install the remaining packages. One question here, okay. I mean, so I mean, can we can't we install like rpm hyphen ivh mq mq star like that? I mean, you can, all the package will be installed, right? So this is the right way.
You can do it. No, actually that's not the right way.
Okay,
that's a shortcut, that's not the right way.
I mean, the sense like I mean, it will install like all the packages, right? We don't have to give each and everything, right? I mean, that's what I was asking.
Yes, that's
because
right.
As you mentioned, like runtime first you have to install, that's what you're saying.
Yeah,
I was wondering,
exactly.
Like how the
exactly. So the thing is, that's just a shortcut, but it'll install all the unnecessary package also, which will give a burden on the operating system, which will give an unnecessary load in the operating system. Why we need that load? This is a VMware.
Okay.
Don't go for the all the things. So I'm installing.
What about the real time? What about in the real time? Also, we
real time are the same six packages. That's all.
Okay, so because I see like a lot of and like packages here, I don't know that MQ series SF bridge you have mentioned. The other one is I have seen like some of the FTP something other package,
right?
Also
those,
there.
Right, those are for different purposes. So right now, don't concentrate on those packages because those are not needed.
Okay.
So let's concentrate on the needed packages list. So runtime,
sure.
Now rpm-ivh mq series samples. Now remaining packages, I'm installing it a single shot. Okay. So now I'm giving one more package, mq series SDK. Then mq series server, then mq series Java, then mq series JRE, and what left? Server is done, SDK is done, sample is done, then runtime is done, then Java, JRE,
GSKit, right?
No, GSKit for SSL, for security we need. We'll see about it in the security concept. Right now it's not needed.
Okay.
So GS means global security kit.
Okay.
So now, now see, JRE is installing. So it will take a couple of minutes. So let's wait for a couple of minutes.
We will go and check the WordPad. What is the last one? Last package.
Now see, Java package installed. Now server package is getting installed. Now SDK, now sample. Okay, it's done. So now five packages are installed. So these five packages, and previously we have installed the runtime package. Total six MQ packages we have installed. So if you want to verify them, you just query them using rpm-qa pipegrep-imq command. Now see, it's showing all the MQ packages, right?
Yes.
Okay, now what is the next step? Okay, now check the MQ configuration if they are met or not. So when we install MQ packages, there is a file called mqconfig opt-mqm-bin. Execute this command, copy, it will show the existing configuration. When I execute this, it will show some parameters like semaphore parameters, shared memory of MQM parameters, and then MQM system settings, all these parameters it will show. So generally in the real time, if you see, there are some are in positive state, some are in failed state, right? So in real time, we have to make sure each and everything must be in positive state. It should not be in failed states. Okay, so till here it is passed, that is fine. Now, if you see here, it is a failed state. The reason why it is in failed state is it is having some system system file max should be see, IBM always recommends these settings should be greater than or equal to this value, but right now it is having only these files. That's the reason it is in failed state.
Okay,
so here we have to take the help of Unix team. Hey, can you please, I mean, we just share them this screenshot to Unix team. Hey, can you please put it according to this value? Now they will change it. Now as soon as they change it, and when we execute this command again, it will be in passive state. Okay, but right now in this VM machine we are not going to change it because just a trial version, so this is fine. No real time transactions are happening, so this is fine. But in real time, make sure everything has to be passive state, not even warm, it has to be in passive state.
Okay.
Where can we go and check it is successfully installed? This is the only validation step, or any other file, log file, something is there?
No, it is already installed. It is already installed successfully. The thing is, when we grab the packages, it is reflecting all the packages from the kernel level. It means NQ is successfully installed.
Mm-hmm.
So this output will show you, yes, my MKE's installation is successful. Okay. Now before, okay, so see, this is the thing we need to check. After that, the final and important step is we need to set as a primary install. So I think Sai, this will answer your question. So you have asked me, right? Do we need to change the permissions for the NQ commands?
Mm-hmm.
So here you will get the answer for your question. So the thing is, although we have installed MQ packages, I am executing MQ command. So DSP MQ VER is a command to check the MQ version which is installed in this machine. So right now we have installed MQ 9.0. It means this command has to show MQ version 9 command, right?
Mm-hmm.
But if I execute this command, it will say command not found. Your command is still not found. Okay. The reason is we need to set our MQ as the primary installation. Then only our MQ commands will get as a recognized commands.
Okay,
so this is the major and very, very important step. Okay, so how to set as a primary installation? It's very simple. What is the installation directory in the Linux?
OPT.
OPTMQM, right? So go
yes.
to the directory OPTMQM. Now, when we go to this directory, we can see a directory called bin.
Mm-hmm.
Go to this bin directory. Now we are in OPTMQM bin. So in this binaries directory, when I list the content, there is a file called setnqinst. So we have to take the help of this file to set our MQ as the primary installation. So how to execute is dot slash, and we need to execute this command with the root user only. Okay. So dot slash setnqinst -i means we are setting my MQ as the primary installation, and -p means path. This is the command. The entire meaning is we are setting MQ as the primary installation. -i stands for setting as a primary. -p means path. So which path I need to set as primary installation? So OPTMQM is the default installation path in MQ. So we have to execute this command. When we execute this command, see, installation one OPTMQM set as the primary installation. It means yes. Now my MQ has been set as a primary installation, and when I execute DSP MQ VR command now it will show you the proper output. This command is now recognized. See, it is showing IBM MQ version 9.0, which is installed on 64-bit Linux operating system. This is the installation path, and this is the working path. This is a trial version. Now see, your MQ commands are started working. Okay, now we are in the root user. Generally, to work on MQ, we need to switch to NQM user. SUNQM is the command to switch to NQM user, or we can use sudo su-NQM. It again depends on project to project, whether you have direct access or you have sudo access. So this is a VM where just executes su-NQM. Now, if I do PreAMI, I am a MQ manager. Now I can do all the MQ commands, DSP, MQ, VR. Now I can create the queue managers. Now I can do whatever the stuff I need. So this confirms you that your MQ installation is done. So this is the way how to execute MQ commands. There is no such a way that we need to give the permission from root to MQ as now. It's not like that.
But I think you installed the broker. I think it's showing the broker part. See that? Okay.
Exactly. I have not installed the broker part, but I just set as profile, broker profile. Okay.
Which one you set as a broker profile? I don't understand.
No, to execute the broker, right? We need to set my MQS setup. My broker will be installed in this path by default. I have installed broker IIB 9.0 in OPT IIB.
Okay. Okay.
So I have set this path in the dot profile path of broker home directory. And I also give an instruction, my broker commands should execute with the MQM user itself. That is the reason it is reflecting.
Okay. Okay. So in dot profile, you have mentioned like MQM, after that you have to execute the...
Exactly. Okay. In okay. dot profile, I have mentioned this.
Okay.
Okay, so let's go on the less minus LRT view cat dot profile. So this is the path I have exported in dot profile of IIB. So see, I have executed, I have in P file, I have again MQSI profile, so that broker profile will be set in this operating system. So that broker commands also execute the same user. Anyway, right now you can ignore this part. This is not needed part. This is the broker.
Okay,
part.
Okay, yes, fine. Yeah.
Okay, so got it, how to install MQ?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's all for today, and I'm going to share this video and the document, and also I'm also going to share the VMware Google Drive links and all, so that when you click on the Google Drive link, required software will be downloaded for you. Okay?
Okay. Okay, I don't know if whether it's the right time to ask this question, okay?
Yeah.
So, okay, as you mentioned, we install the MQ software, right? So for example, these are like single installation right now, okay?
Exactly.
So when you say multi-instance, okay, like we need to mention okay. the same stuff like set MQ install hyphen P something, right? Or I mean, if I'm not wrong, okay? Just trying
okay.
to...
Let me give you explanation here. Okay, so by default, MQ will be installed in OPT MQM. Like when we execute RPM-IVH and when we give that MQ series runtime package, so all these packages will be installed by default in OPT MQM, right? This is
okay,
for single
okay.
installation. So if you okay. consider if it's a multi installation, like I need to have MQ8, I mean, I need to have say MQ9 and MQ10, both are on the same machine.
Mm-hmm.
No, don't go that much long. Okay, consider MQ7 and MQ7.5. MQ7.1, MQ7.5 both should be on the same machine. Consider this
okay.
is my requirement. Okay.
okay,
now consider it is already there with the MQ7 in OPT MQM. MQ7 is already there. Now,
okay.
multi installation is supported from MQ7. Now, I need to install MQ7.5 also.
Okay.
Now, the thing is, I will create another file system, say OPT MQM 75.
Mm-hmm.
So here it is having MQ7.0 binaries. Now I need to install MQ75. So I have created another file system MQ75. Now how I've installed the package is in the same machine RPM-IVH, -prefix,
mm-hmm.
and I will give my customized path MQ7.5, and I will give MQ series runtime, 7.5 package, -75 to do that. Now this package will be installed in this machine. It is not going to install in this machine. Now in MQ75 we have MQ75, and in OPT MQM we are having MQ7.0. Both packages are there. Okay.
Okay.
Now
okay.
the thing is, the question is, if you want to install MQ7.0 binaries, the thing what you need to do is you have to go to the absolute path. So like. OPT MQM bin, and when use DSP MQVR, this command will show you the output of MQ7.0 version. And if
okay.
I go to bin DSP MQVR, it will show you MQ7.5 output.
Okay.
So you have to execute the absolute path. But still, there is one more shortcut. Executing entire absolute path on each and every case, that wouldn't be an ideal scenario. There is a way. The thing is, cd opt npm bin. Do you see this setmq env setmq environment?
Yeah.
So this file show you which version environment you need to set. You need to set 7.0 environment or you need to set 7.5 environment. Okay, so setmq inst is, it's a permanent fix, it's a permanent, it is 7.5, that's all.
Okay.
And setmq env is for temporary. You can switch the versions. You can switch the different versions. So
okay.
It will be dot slash setmq env. Okay. So it's proceeded with the source command. If you execute source setmq env, I mean, if you go to 7.0 binary and if you execute this, so it will set for 7.0 environment. And if you go to 7.5 setmq env and if you execute this path, it will set for a 7.5 environment.
Okay, so basically what is the path we had to mention? Like if once we enter the setmq environment, after that we had to mention this.
Cd opt mqm bin.
Okay.
Consider this opt mqm is having 7.5 installed, I mean 7.0 installed.
Okay.
Now, when I execute source setmq env, it will actually here multi installation is not there, so command will not execute. So,
okay,
it will set 7.0 environment. So, if you
okay.
go for opt mqm 75 bin, currently this path is not there, that's why it's showing no file. Consider these parties exist, and if you execute source setmq env, it will say that it will set the environment for 7.5 binaries.
Okay, only for temporary and until that session, right?
Exactly, until that session. When you log out, that's all, it's gone.
Okay, that's all. Okay,
that's everything.
So first thing is we need to run the command is dot setmq env, right? Then
exactly.
Source setmq, right?
Exactly.
Okay,
hope you got some. I mean, Vivek, don't confuse about Sai's question. He was asking some in depth about multi instance. He's having some doubts. I'm just clarifying it. But the bottom line is this is the document we need to follow for successful installation of MQ, which is very simple. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. So that's all for today. So tomorrow we'll start with the command line interfaces.
There is one thing, fixpack installation also we need to.
Fixpack will not now. Fixpack, don't go for now. We'll do that.
Okay.
We'll definitely do that. So let's complete our MQ stuff now, or MQ based stuff now. Later on we'll go for the upgrade. Later on we'll go for the fixpack. Later on we'll go for the pubsub. Everything.
The even the backup and the restore, right? Like for example, if the the queue manager.
That will cover under the modules. We have modules, right? We have the
okay.
Syllabus, course content.
Okay.
So that will be covered under this thing, module 9. Okay. The thing is, we'll go in order. When we miss the order, you won't understand the concept.
Sure. Okay.
Okay. So let's wait for 20 days. Everything, whatever we're expecting, you will definitely get.
Okay.
Fine.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's all for today. Let's wind up the session and we'll meet tomorrow at 6 a.m. IST. Okay?
Sure. Yeah, thank you.
Okay, thanks, Vivek. Thanks, Sai. Have a good day.
Thanks, yeah. Bye.